You're still watching Rise 360, and I'm your host, Catchy Offiet. Now, you see, the music industry stays as fresh as ever. So, to keep up with all the headline-grabbing stories, how about we take a look at some music news? Now, this particular situation broke our hearts. Tributes are being paid to American R&B singer James Ingram, who died in Los Angeles at the age of 66. Now, the Grammy-winning and Oscar nominee co-wrote Michael Jackson's PYT with Quincy Jones, and he earned 8 top 40 hits, 2 Grammy wins, 14 Grammy nominations, and multiple Oscar and Golden Globe nominations during his career. In a statement, Quincy Jones said his heart ached with the news of the passing of his baby brother. TV producer Shauna Rhimes said the world has lost a genius, while DJ Premier called him a soul legend. Head on out the door. Just once, can we figure out what we keep doing wrong? His music definitely lives on. Now, Christina Aguilera is the latest star to head to Sin City for her own Las Vegas residency. We're so excited for her. So, announcing the news on Ellen's show, she revealed that she's playing 16 dates at Planet Hollywood starting at the end of May. Now, the show will be titled The Experience. All the recent residencies have included Britney Spears, Gwen Stefani, Celine Dion, and Lady Gaga. So, Christina Aguilera is definitely in great company. And we have been talking about the Super Bowl halftime show. But you see, Maroon 5, who we thought would perform, they still are, but they will not do a press conference ahead of this Sunday's controversial Super Bowl halftime show. Now, it bucks the trend for entertainers, including Justin Timberlake, Lady Gaga, and Katy Perry, who have faced questions from the press prior to the event. So, in a statement, the NFL said the band had been working hard on a show that will meet and exceed expectations. The band have come under fire, so, because they accepted the gig after several artists turned it down in protest at the NFL's treatment of former quarterback Colin Kaepernick, as well as other players who have kneeled in protest during the playing of the U.S. national anthem. And it looks like this film has definitely come to stay. So Lady Gaga's film, A Star Is Born, is now the highest-grossing musician-starring movie in global box office. And you see, this really has us concerned, because this movie has grossed just under $414 million worldwide, beating former record holder my favorite movie, The Bodyguard, which starred Whitney Houston and Kevin Costner. While A Star Is Born recently got an Oscar nomination that, you know, would likely help it continue stacking up, you know, those box office dollars. Is there something else you're searching for? Bradley Cooper for the win. Well, it looks like Nigerian artist Mr. Easy is about to have another strong year. So first, Mr. Easy kicked things off in 2019 with a major announcement that he'll be performing at this year's Coachella Music Festival. And now, he has announced a huge tour around 16 countries in North America. His Life is Easy Volume 2 tour will see him making stops in Atlanta, Toronto, Detroit, San Francisco, and several other cities. Now, this tour will take place between March 16th and April 18th. Well, that is all the music news today, but don't go anywhere, because you have to stay plugged in so you can get tuned in as we find out what's been creating such a buzz on the most popular platform in the world, social media.